Welcome dear students to our technofund.kvs YouTube channel. In this particular video, we will further revise the concepts of Python which we have covered in class 7th. Now, today we will discuss about the sequence-based programming. As we know that programming works on a particular algorithm, and that is why we need some particular logic in our programs or our softwares which we develop. So initially, or we can say in the simple terms, we learned about the sequence based programming. Actually, if we simply make some programs, then we will write some simple steps in a particular sequence. There should not be any condition or looping or anything else in order in which we are writing the instructions. In that same order, the instructions will get executed by the Python interpreter. Let us take an example to understand better this. Suppose we may have to make a program in Python in which we have to accept the age of a person. That is why we are using here the age equals to int input enter your age. As you know, input function is used to accept some particular values from the user at the runtime. And this int function is converting that input to integer data type. Int is used for integer data type here because if we are using input function, then the value which is entered by the user at the runtime will be of string data type by default. So because age is a numeric value, integer value, that is why we are using here int function to convert that particular string value into age. Now here we are going to accept the age of the person, and in next two statements we are telling the user that you have entered age. We are printing the value of the variable age which is entered by the user. Your age after 5 years will be age plus 5. We are also printing the value of the age of the person after 5 years by using plus operator. So this can be an example of sequence based programming, as we are writing statements in a specific sequence order, and this particular order the program will get executed. As you can see, the output will be just like that. Enter your age. Suppose the user enters here 14. Now we are printing the value which is entered by the user at the runtime. You have entered age 14. Your age after 5 years will be 19. So you can see that the three statements we have written in our program, and Python executes these three statements in that particular order. So this is the simplest sequence based programming techniques. But in general, we have more complex programs. So that is why we will learn about the if else statement, as you have learned in class 7th. Now, what is if else statement? Whenever in a particular program we need to specify some conditions, or we need to execute some statements or instructions based on a specific condition, then we will use this particular if else statement. The syntax of the if else statement is, you can see on the screen, if condition. If this condition is true, then these n statements will get executed by the Python. As you can see here, if the condition is true, then these n statements will get executed. If the condition is not true, then the Python will execute the statements given here in the else part. Here, this is the else part of our if else statement. Also, it is not mandatory to give else every time we are going to specify if. And we can also have a if without a else part, but as per the problem demands, as per the situation demands, we have to specify or use else. This is the decision of the user to solve the particular program in which he or she needs, whether he has to give the else part or avoid it. So this is the else part. If else we can understand this one by using a particular program. Now let us see. We take an example in which we have to check whether the input number is smaller than 100 or not. So we are writing these statements. Just see these statements. Num equals to int input, enter a number. We are accepting a value, a number from the user. Then we are printing back, giving the message that you have entered the number num. Whatever the number user enters, it will be displayed here. Now what we are using here, we are putting a condition here, if num greater than 100. If this, the value of num variable is greater than 100, means this condition is true. Then the Python executes the print num is greater than 100. The Python will give a message back to the user that the value of num is greater than 100 and leave the else part. If the value entered by the user of num is not greater than 100, then this condition becomes false. And as soon as this condition becomes false, the Python automatically goes into the else part and avoid the statements given in the if condition and executes the statements given in the else condition, means it will print num is less than equal to 100. So let us see its runtime program. Suppose user enter here number 101. So we have got this message, you have entered the number 101. So we will have the message 101 is greater than 100 as based on the condition, because the first condition 101 is greater than 100 is true. So we are getting the first message. Now in the second part, or in the second run, we can see we are entering a value 99, which is less than 100, means this first condition of if is false. Then the Python automatically executes this instruction of the else part. So 99 is less than equals to 100. So we have discussed here about some example of if else, and I hope you have revised and recapped the if else statement in an enjoyable and interactive manner. Thank you for watching this video.